Well, he is our favorite acerbic doctor from Scrubs. Now he's going to be our favorite priest in The Good Catholic. Welcome, John C. McGinley. How are you?
Good morning. Fantastic.
Good to see you. You know, here at KTLA, we're very full service because during the break, Chris went over and lint lifted off your jacket.
That goes under the guy rule column. You got to guys take care of guys. It's the way it goes.
Dog or cat?
Both. We got them all.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so now you're dander free, so we can kind of get started.
It's a burden lifted.
There you go. I'm so glad. You know, it's so funny. I miss Scrubs so much. Everyone misses Scrubs so much. Do you miss Scrubs as much as we miss Scrubs?
No, no. We did 200 episodes over 9 years. If you didn't get it out of your system over 9 years, it begs the question, what were you waiting for?
Really? You don't miss it at all?
No, we 190 episodes. We rang that one out.
Yeah, all right, you got it. All right, you're doing The Good Catholic. Tell me about that. You've already actually won some. There's some buzz about this. You've won some film festival awards. It's a romantic comedy about a young priest dedicated to his calling, but yet he's kind of a different priest.
So the young writer director Paul Schulberg, who put this together, his father was a priest. He met a nun. They fell in love.
Oh, really?
And they had to reconcile that union because the church obviously can't accommodate its employees falling for each other. So, cut to Paul 40 years later. In our story, the hero is a priest who falls in love with a civilian, not a nun.
Okay.
And the story becomes about the three-way tug of war between this woman that he's falling for, Danny Glover, who plays an old school, very pragmatic Old Testament priest, and my priest, who's this very progressive, God is love, love is God. And it's a three-way tug of war for this young kid's soul.
Right. Were you attracted to this because you're very religious or because it was a very interesting scenario?
I grew up impacted in a really positive way by Jesuits at a school called Del Barton in Morristown, New Jersey. And so I had a very profoundly different exposure to the church and not diminishing any of the horrible things that have happened, but I had a great exposure to the church. And so it was easier for me to bring that back, to scratch that itch and get at what were really positive, impactful men in my life that have created the guy I am now. And so to go back and be able to visit that and play a Jesuit was pretty fun.
Well, and I like you made him super relatable. Like, he's kind of a chain-smoking sports fanatic, right?
Yes.
Did you kind of add that into the script, or was that your own touch?
No, that was all on the page. Look, with these low-budget independents, you have 18 days to shoot them, so everything has to be on the page because there's no time to do anything other than what's on the page. And there was a really well-constructed blueprint to work off of, and we did.
Let's look at a clip from The Good Catholic.
Come on.
What, Father?
Even the Franciscans have some rules about this.
Let me check, Father. And cometh game day, 'tis okay to go forth in the colors of thine chosen team, unless thine chosen team is the Purdue Boilermakers or the Kentucky Wildcats.
God is good.
Tip off's in 5 minutes. I'm making my nachos.
Oh, don't remember that verse.
That's the first time I've heard that one as well. Yeah, it was good.
It's a very flexible document.
Right, I like it. Real quickly, Stand Against Evil, you've got the second season coming up. Congratulations.
November 1, we start again. We had a great year last year. I'm off to Comic-Con in New York here in a couple of weeks, and we'll pump as much air into Stand Against Evil Season 2 on IFC as we can.
We love seeing you, John. Thank you so much for coming
Thanks for having me.
So good to see you. Okay, The Good Catholic is in theaters and available on demand now. We'll be right back. Thanks again.
Thank you, John.
Good to see you guys.
You too.